Hey, art family, if you like this one, the full-length version's on Patreon.
They are skillful.
Hello, art family. And thanks, of course, to all the new subscribers. For this video, I wanted to take you to a scene in Ocean City, Maryland at sunrise to try to capture that really bright, luminescent, vibrant morning light, but also to do a subject matter that would experiment some with texture and getting texture in your watercolor, some tools that you can use. I'm working on a Saunders watercolor block. It's 9x12 and cold press paper. You can get these blocks in hot press, cold press, or rough. I have not done a whole lot with rough. In fact, I need to do a video where I get some, but I pretty much exclusively work in cold press. I've done some watercolor on hot press, which is the very smooth version, and you get a lot of texture and interesting things where the pigment sits on top of the paper more than being absorbed into it so evenly. But I kind of prefer the even absorption of pigment of the cold press paper. So I'm starting out the sketch by pre-wetting the page to chisel out some of the shapes that I want to keep light and separate. And then I'm going to get a fairly even gradient across the whole sky. And I want to keep it extremely light because this is morning light and it's very, very bright. So all the elements that I'm putting down on top of this are going to be much, much darker. But I do want to give that sense of light and luminescence in the sky. And you can see across the sky right now behind the sketch, off to the right, we have very blue, kind of greenish blue into a blue. And then you have a very light band across the bottom of the sky. And then over towards the actual sun, it gets very, very rich and warm. So I use a lot of yellow ochre, moving into almost nothing towards the horizon line. So we'll often put in a big yellow ochre area with a ton of water and then come back with a thirsty brush and draw some of that back out. I used some clean water and splashed it onto the page on the corn areas where the corn has been chopped down, and it creates this very scattered texture. So I just splashed clean water right on top of my even gradient just to break that shape up and try to replicate some of that uncontrolled texture that I'm experiencing all around me at the time. It looked like a war zone out there. It was all scattered and chopped down, and it had just been freshly harvested. For the shadow side, I'm using the complementary colors of ultramarine and cobalt and cadmium orange and burnt sienna to really get that, push that complement and get that luminescent feeling from the variety of those far opposite colors. And this is something I wanted to talk about, is using a knife. I carry this pen knife or pocket knife everywhere with me for watercolor, and it's a great way to cut into the texture of a laid down wet area like what I just did. So bringing back some highlights if you want to bring back some highlights, and also if it's sharp enough, you can cut a thin layer off the top of the page by using just the point, and you'll get a very uneven scrape. You could use a razor blade is a really nice thing for that too. If you carry one of those with you as well, you can get a really nice uneven sort of glistening highlight across the tops of things. It's a really handy tool. I'm trying to vary the wash moving around the inside of this shed because I know I have some areas where it's picking up that atmospheric rich blue light, but I also have a lot of warm areas, especially up in the roof or the kind of hood of the shed, because light is bouncing off this very bright yellow ground and shooting up into the inside. So you're getting a lot of warms on the inside of the shed as well, especially in the darker corners and occlusion areas where light doesn't really get to. It's going to be warm because light still bounces all around the area and zigzags up into the little pockets. I'm working now on these middle ground trees. I'm using ultramarine and raw sienna, as well as straight from the tube cadmium red directly into the trees, because I want to get that rich variation of having those complements that sort of make a neutral gray if you step back from the picture. But I also just want a lot of variation in those colors, but I want to increase that saturation from the far, far distant trees, which I sort of accidentally covered up a little more than I meant to. So now I'm getting into the darker bits and the bones of this shed, which I'm not terribly interested in. I was really interested in the major shapes of this composition that sort of brings you to the space. I was also really interested in the boat and the shed, but the actual bones, the wood, I'm not spending time drawing and noodling away at the specific detail. I just want to give the sense that it's there within context so that when you look at the total picture, it will make sense within the frame of what you're looking at, that this is the wood and, you know, these darker areas are the darker pockets, but I'm not going to get in there and really be too specific with the detail on that stuff. So I'm starting to work on the cornfield that I'm standing in, which is really like a war zone. It looks like a bomb went off. So there's just corn everywhere and scattered pieces of stalk everywhere. So I'm using the side of the brush to rake down a lot of texture, try to get some of those vertical highlights and little pockets and places. I'm gonna splash clean water across the whole thing just to break up that evenness. And then I'm using my knife. I'm switching from brush to knife and brush to knife just to carve back into it. Also splashing clean water on it just to break those shapes, continue to break up that area because this is a very textured area. And I want to use a principle of a kind of scattershot of information so that there's so much information, it's not important anymore. It's like a run-on sentence of information. And my concise statement that I want to keep beautiful and tight is going to be all within the value statement of the shed and the machine or the combine behind the shed. But with the cornfield, I want to keep it loose, keep it scratchy, and less important than the shed and the darker value of the shadow coming off the shed, as well as the boat on the back end of the shed, which I was also really fascinated by. I'm transitioning from warm to cool, burnt sienna to ultramarine or cobalt, as I move closer to the object to away from the object, because these long, rich, beautiful morning or evening shadows, they get very, very blue because they're picking up a lot of that atmospheric light. And now, just to make sure that the bottom is not competing with the top, I'm coming back with a darker value and then noodling away at some of the detail here, just giving some form and texture, trying to pick up some of those semi-highlights within the shadow. That's a good thing to always keep in mind, is that even in the shadows, you still have some highlights or lighter lights. At this point, I was surrounded by birds. There were buzzards everywhere over my head, so I wanted to capture that and also to fix a mistake I made earlier where I dropped a brush and made a weird, awkward spot on the page. So just put in some birds. It gives a nice, expansive feeling to a composition, and it's a way to clean up a little mistake I made. Well, that's it for this demo of this sunrise sketch in Ocean City. I hope you got a lot out of it. Of course, I'm always around if you have questions. I appreciate you watching the video. I appreciate the subscriptions and the continued support. And I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, happy sketching.